This video introduces the railing edit mode, which is used to edit the geometry of the individual railing sub-elements created by the ARCHICAD railing tool. As shown in other clips, ARCHICAD's railing elements are composed of hierarchical sub-elements. The railing tool offers an edit mode. This is similar to the edit mode available for the curtain wall tool. To activate the edit mode, select the railing you want to edit, and click the Edit button appearing near the lower right area of the railing. The railing toolbox appears in the upper left corner of the viewpoint. Edit mode is available not only in 3D, but in floor plan and section elevation and interior elevation viewpoints as well. Commands and options on the railing toolbox depend on the active viewpoint. The toolbox includes only those options and commands that are valid and relevant in that viewpoint. The railing toolbox is divided into three parts. The topmost part has buttons for each component of the railing, and clicking any of the buttons with the eye icon lets you toggle the visibility of the corresponding component. The first button toggles the visibility of segments and nodes, which lets you display the reference surface of the railing. If you click any of the nodes represented by the thick black lines, they will be selected and you can edit them. By clicking the black selection hotspots, the railing node pet palette is displayed, offering various editing commands. Similarly, clicking any of the reference surfaces selects the corresponding railing segment. The railing reference line is also displayed. By clicking the reference line, the railing segment pet palette is displayed, offering various editing commands. Please watch the clip titled Railing Editing, Nodes and Segments in this playlist to familiarize yourself with the commands offered by railing node and segment pet palettes. The other seven buttons of the top part of the railing toolbox offer toggles for the display of the top rail, handrails, rails, posts, inner posts, balusters, and panels of the railing. If you select the top rail, you can click any node or segment of the top rail polygon, and the pet palette will contain three commands. The Offset All Edges command lets you graphically modify the reference line offset value of the railing, which will, in effect, offset the whole railing geometry from its reference line. The Stretch Height command lets you graphically modify the railing segment height value of the railing, which will, in effect, modify the height of the top rail. The Modify Angle command can do two different things. With horizontal movement in the editing plane, it lets you graphically modify the segment slanting value of the railing, which will in effect slant the reference plane of the railing segment. However, with vertical movement in the editing plane, it lets you graphically modify the segment skewing value of the railing, which will, in effect, skew the railing segment's components in the reference plane of the railing segment. If you select a handrail, you can click any of its nodes or segments. The editing plane is displayed. With horizontal movement in the editing plane, you can graphically modify the horizontal offset value of the handrail, which will offset all edges of the selected handrail. With vertical movement in the editing plane, you can graphically modify the handrail height value of the handrail, which will modify the vertical position of the handrail. If you select a rail, you can click any of its nodes or segments. The editing plane is displayed, and you can graphically edit its horizontal offset value with horizontal movements in the editing plane. This will offset all edges of the selected rail, or its rail height value with vertical movements in the editing plane, which will modify the vertical position of the rail. If you select a post or an inner post, hotspots will appear on both their ends. By dragging the top or bottom hotspots, you can graphically modify their top offset or bottom offset value, respectively, which will in effect modify their length at the top or bottom, respectively. Additionally, inner posts have a drag command on their pet palette. By using this, you can adjust the distance of the inner post from the previous inner post of the railing segment pattern. If you select a baluster, all balusters of that type will be selected, and hotspots will appear on both their ends. By dragging the top or bottom hotspots, you can graphically modify their top height or bottom height value, respectively, which will in effect modify their length at their top or bottom, respectively. Balusters also have hotspots on all four corners of their bounding box. If you click any of them, the pet palette will offer commands to resize this bounding box horizontally and vertically. Balusters will always be generated within the resized bounding box. Additionally, the pet palette offers the drag command. By using this, you can modify the horizontal offset of the balusters. If you select a panel, it will be selected with hotspots at all four of its corners. You can click any of its corners or sides, and the pet palette will offer commands to offset relevant sides of the panel. Additionally, the pet palette offers the drag command, by using which you can modify the horizontal offset of the panel. The second part of the railing toolbox contains the environment button. By clicking it, you can hide the environment of the railing, or you can display it to see the exact model context in which the railing is located. In the bottom part of the toolbox, the railing settings button lets you access the railing settings dialog, where you can modify settings that affect the railing element as a whole, or modify the settings of any of its components. Finally, the Exit Edit Mode button closes the railing toolbox and returns you to the ARCHICAD modeling environment. All the buttons of the railing toolbox described above are available in both the floor plan viewpoint and the 3D viewpoint. In section elevation and interior elevation viewpoints, however, the top part of the toolbox is not available. In these viewpoint types, you can only toggle the visibility of the environment, access the railing dialog, and exit edit mode. Please also watch the next clip in this playlist as well, as it continues to present railing editing capabilities.